Hello? Is this thing on? Oh, darn technology. Hello? Oh, there's the red light. Boy, is that bright. Hello. My name is Christine Johnson, the crazy cat lady, and I'm here to tell you puppets about another interesting cat. Oh, it's a bit hot in here now, isn't it? I'm afraid that I was the one who caused global warming. It was last year on my birthday. We created a cake for me and we lit all the candles. But alas, there were too many candles and the heat ruptured the ozone. So now you have me to thank for that. But anyways, that's not why I'm here. I'm here to talk about cats. Now, what cat should we talk about today? We could talk about the fascinating cheetah with its speed, or the interesting snow leopard with its stealth. Oh, I've got it! Oh, we'll talk about the caracal with its jumping. Oh, you've never heard of the caracal? Oh my, it's one of my favorite animals in the entire world. And that's saying something, because I know at least 10 animals. My memory's not gone yet, you know. Neither is my hair or my good looks. Now, let's see, the caracal. The caracal has little black tufts on its ears, which is where it gets its name. It's based off of a Turkish word, which means black ear in English. And that's where the word caracal comes from. And its scientific name is, can you guess? Caracal caracal. Oh, that name just gives me shivers, and I don't know why. Now, let's see. The caracal is one of the most interesting cats for many reasons. Well, it can be melanistic. Have you ever heard of the Black Panther? Oh, of course you have, puppet. Now, the Black Panther is not an actual different animal. It's just a melanistic form of the leopard or the jaguar. Now, this is essentially the opposite of albinism, or being albino. It makes your fur black. Now, this is not necessarily a disadvantage for cats, as it helps them blend in. So it is not uncommon to see a black animal like that. However, if it was an albino caracal, that might not be as common, because prey items would be able to see you coming from very far way off. Whew, I need to rest for a moment. Oh, last time I stopped to rest, in an antique store. They almost sold me, by golly. Oh, I barely made it to the birth certificate registration office in time. I had to renew my birth certificate, you see. Apparently, those things can expire. Anyways, oh dear. Oh, okay. Where were we? Oh yes, the caracal. So, what would you like to learn about the caracal? Why it is so interesting? I will tell you why. It is the fastest and the heaviest of all the small cats. This does not include the large cats, of course, because they're small cats. But I think by far the most interesting bit of the caracal is this. Watch and learn. Oh, did you see that, puppet? No, not me dancing while you were watching that video. I was, it was the can-can. But, were you watching that video? Did you see that? That caracal jumped a good 10 feet up in the air. How is that possible? How can a cat do that? We're like 7 feet tall, and we can only jump like, what, 2 feet off the ground? Well, take a look at your house cat at home, puppet, and you'll see it can jump quite a long ways, long and tall. Now, the caracal, it needs to survive in the wild. And what does it eat? Normally, it eats small rodents, or the close living relative of the elephant, the hyrax, or birds. Birds are a staple diet of the caracal. And if it comes upon a patch of, say, guinea fowl, and it sees a whole flock of them, it might try and catch as many as 3 or 4 before the flock escapes. It can catch 1 on the ground, perhaps 2. Oh, excuse me. Oh, but perhaps even 3 or 4 if it manages to leap up in the air and swat them down. Now, the caracal, besides eating all these animals, has even been known to attack ostrich, just leaping onto their back. I don't think anything came of it, though. Oh, it'd be like a velociraptor attacking an Argentinosaurus. The very idea would be laughable. Speaking of Argentinosaurus, have you seen that movie Jurassic Park? Oh, did that bring back the memories for me? Oh, I remember when we used to have to run away from dinosaurs to survive. Oh, it wasn't that long ago either. Actually, I suppose it was a very long time ago, now wasn't it? A long, long time ago. Oh, I'm getting up there in the years, aren't I? Anyways, enough about that. The caracal, one of the most fascinating creatures on Earth. Thank you for joining me, Poppets, and I will see you next time. Remember, I'm Christine Johnson, and I haven't lost my looks, for I'm the crazy cat lady from down the street. It's been cool, Poppets. Keep it real.